Hello students, so this is the last topic of this particular chapter, columns with initial curvature. So this is a theory what we are going to see, and little lengthy theory. So here, columns with initial curvature, so we are going to understand it that after considering what is the initial curvature, that what is the maximum curvature, and then with this we will going to find out what is the maximum deflection, maximum stress. Okay, so let us see the diagram. So in this figure we can see that AB, right, AB is of length L. Okay, it is hinged at both the ends. The column is having initial curvature of this position, that is A C dash B. Okay, actual column is ACB, initial curvature is AC dash B. Okay, now let us apply a crippling load P. Let the P be the crippling load at which the column has just buckled, that is it has just started bending. So this position is shown by A double C dash B. Okay, C double dash B. So initial shape of the column may be a can be assumed as a circular. We can assume it as a circular, we can assume it as a parabolic or sinusoidal without making much difference to the final result. But most common form what we use for this, so equation, we use it as y dash equal to c sine of pi x by l. So we express it in this form, whereas y dash is the distance for the deflection initial, for the initial curvature. Okay, that is the distance here. Now C is the maximum initial deflection. What is C? Capital C is a maximum initial deflection, and y dash is initial deflection at a distance x from A. Okay, initial deflection at a distance x, sorry, this is x. Initial deflection at a distance x from A. Okay, that is the y dash. And C is a maximum deflection. C is a maximum initial deflection. Now, when we differentiate this formula for one time, so we can write it as dy dash by dx. So C is a some initial deflection we have assumed. So we can rewrite it as C into pi by L. Okay, when we differentiate, sine becomes cos, pi x by l. One more time, let us differentiate it. D square y dash by dx square is equal to c into pi by l into minus pi by l. Cos becomes minus sine. So, it is sine of pi x by l. So, we can rewrite it as C pi square L square sine of pi of x by L. Okay. Now, at the crippling load, the final shape of the column is as A double dash C B. Now, let Y be the final deflection. Okay. Let Y be the final deflection. So, at this point, it should be in the final deflection. At a distance x from A. So it is somewhere, okay, at any distance x from A. So what is the change of deflection? So initial deflection was y dash and the final deflection is y. So change in deflection we can write as change in deflection. We can write it as y minus y dash. And let us call it as y of star. Okay, that is the difference. Now this change of deflection is due to, why it is happening? Because of some moment getting created because of this crippling load. Okay. So this change of deflection is due to the bending moment equal to M is equal to load into perpendicular distance P into Y. Okay. Now bending moment at the section due to crippling load is, we can write it as bending moment at the section. This change in deflection DFLE is because of P into Y, and this we use same equation we can write in a negative way. Okay, P into Y. as we know that it is if it is deflecting like this, it is concavity, you may consider, or it may you may consider it as a anticlockwise. So that is the equation minus p into y. So bending moment, we know the other bending. Till now we were doing all theory the similar way. We have one bending equation, now we know the other bending equation. At any section we write it as dEi d square y by dx square. Okay, so here d square y, let us do the slight change here because here we have to consider difference. So we can rewrite this equation as EI d square y minus y dash by dx square. Okay, now equating two equations, that is equation number 1 and equation number 2. Equating these two equations, we can write, so we can write it as EI d square y minus y dash divided by dx square is equal to minus p into y. So again we can split the equation, d square y by dx square minus d square y dash by dx square is equal to minus py by ei. Ei we have taken to the other side. Again rearrange the terms. This is minus, this is minus, so let us change the sign all over. So bring the equation here, py by ei and d square y dash by dx square. So it is equal to, see, d square y by dx square is equal to this expression, we have already have it. So substitute it like c pi square by h square, that is minus sine of pi x by l. So we get from this d square y dash by dx square. Okay, so this is, we are simply writing it like this. So let the solution of the above differential equation, so let us assume the solution. Okay, let the solution for the above differential equation, solution be y equals to mc sine of pi x by l. Let m is a constant of integration. So the m value can be obtained by finding the value of d square y by dx square, and then we'll substitute this value in the equation. We will substitute in this equation, this is d square y dash by dx square. Let us call it as equation number 3. Let pi equals 2, m into c sine of pi x by l. Okay, where m is a constant of integration. So m can be obtained by finding the value of d square by dx square, and we'll substitute in equation number 3 and value of y in equation number 3 and 4. Okay, so let us find out. Let us find d square y by dx square and substitute in equation number 3. Now differentiate equation number, now differentiate equation number 4. So we can write it as dy by dx is equal to m into c into pi by l, so sine will become cos here, pi x by l, again differentiate above equation. So we will get d square y by dx square, now cos will become minus sine, so my m minus m into c, this constant will come out, sine of pi x by l. Now let us substitute these values in equation number d square y by dx square we have got. So let us substitute this in equation number 3. Which is equation number 3? I'm showing you, okay? In this equation, let us substitute that value. So we'll get it minus mc pi square by l square sine of pi x by l plus p by ei into mc. C became little. MC sine of pi x by L, which is equal to minus C pi square by L square sine of pi x by L. So cancelling sine terms from both the sides. Okay, here sine pi x, sine pi x, here sine pi x by L. So this is common. So let us cancel it from this side. So we will arrive at minus m of c into pi square by L square plus p by ei into mc equal to minus c pi square by L square. So again cancelling c term from both sides, okay, cancel this c terms from both the sides. So we will arrive at m pi square by L square minus p by ei. So we are also changing the sign here, minus plus, so we'll make it plus minus into m is equal to pi square by L square. So further when we simplify it, we get it as m is equal to pi square by L square divided by pi square by L square minus p by ei 1 by 1 minus p L square ei pi square. So now dividing numerator and divider denominator both by pi square L square. So we know that PE is equal to Euler's load. So Euler's load, we know pi square ei by L square. We know this formula already. So substitute this value. Substitute this value in this above equation. Okay. So substitute it here. So we further substitute and when we simplify it, we get it as m equals to PE divided by PE minus P. Okay, so when we simplify, we arrive at this equation. So the above equation gives the value of m in terms of Euler's load and axial load. So substituting this value of m in equation number 3, equation number 4, okay, we will substitute this value in equation number 4. So we will arrive at y is equal to PE by PE minus P into C into sine of pi x by L. So this gives the final deflection at any distance x from A. So this is such a lengthy theory. Okay, but this is the way for initial curvature. We have to follow this procedure. So we have arrived at the initial deflection we got. If you remember the initial deflection. So we got the value of initial deflection y over here. Now coming to the maximum deflection. Now let us see the maximum deflection. Now for maximum deflection. So the deflection will be maximum at the midpoint, okay, when x is equal to L by 2, deflection will be maximum. So let this maximum deflection as, let us call it as y max, okay, let us call it as y max. So we can say that at x equal to L by 2, we will get that, we can write y equals to y max. So above equation, this particular equation, now what to name? We have given names as equation number 4. So let us name it as equation number 5. So we will substitute equation, this value in above equation number 5. So we can write it as y max is equal to PE divided by PE, P suffix E minus P into C into sine of pi x. That is, it will become L by 2. Okay. So when we substitute these values, we get it as PE, PE minus P and sine of pi by 2. Okay. Sine of pi by 2 is 90. So we can, it will become, this term will become 1. So we will get it as this y max as this expression we are getting. Okay. So maximum deflection is this. Now what is the maximum stress? So for maximum stress, is due to the direct stress and bending stress. So we have seen it before. Sigma max is because of direct stress and bending stress. So we know this equation. Now the bending stress should be compressive. It will be maximum where bending moment is maximum. So bending moment, we know bending moment is the load into deflection. Hence maximum bending moment will be, so max, maximum bending moment will be P into Y max. Now we know the Y max formula already. Y max is equal to PE by P minus PE into C. So maximum bending moment, we can write, therefore maximum bending moment is equal to M is equal to P into PE by PE minus P into C. Okay. So now sigma b is equal to M by Z. Now again substitute M value as this expression and Z. Okay, where Z is equal to I by YC is equal to, we can write in previous this radius of gyration, we in previous problem we have considered it as R for Paris formula. Okay, so K and R, somewhere it is K, somewhere it is R. So notation, it can be anything as per our whatever books we prefer. So somewhere it is R or somewhere it is K. So AK square by YC. So when we substitute this value in sigma B, okay, substitute this value in sigma B, then here YC, it is a distance from the neutral axis of the extreme layer in compression. Okay, so when we substitute it, after once we substitute here, then for a final formulation for sigma max is equal to substitute sigma naught, expression for sigma naught, and then sigma B. Okay, when we substitute all and the and when we solve it, then we arrive at the expression that sigma max by sigma naught minus 1 minus sigma naught by sigma E is equal to C into YC by K square. So the term PE by PE minus P in this theory, so it is written in terms of stresses. Okay, so we can rewrite it as PE is nothing but, if we write in terms of stresses, so we have to divide by area. So again PE by A minus P by A. So we can rewrite it as sigma E minus sigma O. So we can rewrite this expression as 1 by 1 minus sigma naught by sigma E. Okay. So in this equation, the C is the initial maximum deflection and YC is the distance of extreme layer in compression from neutral axis. Okay. So this is the for the initial curvature of the column or stress. So this is the lengthy theory. So you need to practice it for 1 hour more time, and then we can it will be easy to understand. But the procedure of considering moment and then equating equation and then finding then again differentiating it, so steps are almost similar. Okay, so students, hope this was a lengthy theory and hope you understood. Thanks for listening this class. Thank you so much.